I mean, I said I liked it earlier, but thank you, Mayor. I do want to add, if we go forward with this, I definitely propose we change the name of Civic Center Drive to whatever, but it doesn't, wouldn't be fitting to have Civic Center Drive in front of our District 56, I don't think, so.
That's interesting. So your thought is matching it?
Matching, or if, what, Lon, I don't know if you have a marketing plan for that, but something that would be, you know, compatible with District 56.
Maybe. First speaker is Donna Rowe. Coming up, Donna. Following Donna Rowe is Myra Sewell.
Good evening, and thank you for hearing us. I do oppose changing any of the street names. Why not just put a monument up that says District 56 or Area 51? Sounds just as stupid. Just to change our driver's license, social security cards, all of our information, you know how it is when you move. It's ridiculous, but when you have to go pay $38 at DMV, that's an expense. Who's going to pay for that? We're not choosing to move. And then on your credit report, when somebody runs a credit report and the address is different, you're dinged because you haven't lived there as long as you said you've lived there because it's a different name. So it really causes a lot of problems with the reporting agencies as well as our mail and all of our inconveniences and having checks remade and all of that. I would just say go with a monument at the corner that says District 56 because nobody knows what it means anyway.
Okay, this is really taller than me. Good evening, Mayor, Vice Mayor, and City Council members. My name is Myra Sewell. I am representing the Ridge Apartments. Thank you. The Ridge Apartments is an affordable housing community with 204 units. I did a count today. We hold a total of 486 people at our property. We are the only private residents of Civic Center Drive, meaning the only residential private citizens that are going to be affected by this change. This proposal would force residents to change their addresses with DMV, Social Security, public assistance, health insurance, schools, financial institutions, utility companies, PG&E and SMUD, employment, friends, family, and a host of many more entities. These tasks will take hours, if not days, to process and finalize. Our residents are already stressed households, and this will have an undue financial impact on them all. The city failed to not only timely inform the business office about this proposal, they failed to directly notify each individual household entirely. Our residents were blindsided by this proposal, causing confusion, upset, and to feel marginalized.
So what started out as a simple suggestion, I think, you know, by our council, I think you soon find out that how much impact it caused, the complexities of multiple different streets. So it's one of those things where it's just a little thread, but you start pulling on it, and there's all kinds of stuff behind there. So I'm fine leaving it alone. I think to someone's point earlier, I mean, we'll create a brand there for ourselves as a community regardless.
What's your address to be 123 District 56, Elk Grove, California? That's confusing. I looked up on the internet. There's not even a street that has a name with a number behind it.
Yeah, we don't want to affect your addresses, not at all. So,
yeah, we're fine.
I'm good with this. Thank you.
Number one.